Hello, everybody. Hello. We've got some folks that are back from last time. We appreciate that. My name is Glenn Plantone. What I wanted to do, actually, because I found myself, we taped it last month, and I watched it and said, I'm constantly looking back here, so I want to program myself to look here so I can stay focused on you guys. Let me see. My name is Glenn Plantone. I'm the host and founder of the Millionaire Real Estate Investment Club of Las Vegas. This is our fourth month, so welcome. For those of you that haven't been here before. Live from Las Vegas, it's Wednesday the 13th. All right. Been dying to do that for a while. Where's my clicker? Get that ready to go. All right. Who was at the first meeting? Come on. Come on up here, guys. Everybody who's at the first meeting, come on up here. Come on. Right now. Rich, you want to pass those out to everybody that was at the first meeting? All right. That's 12, I think, so that should hopefully be enough to cover you. Very good. Oh, I got to go back on this side again. All right, who's at meeting two? Okay, you don't get anything, but thanks for coming in. Appreciate that. Newcomers, how many newcomers do we have? We got a lot. I know Kevin I've known, a lot of folks that I've never met before. Fed, what's your name?
Rob.
Okay, Rob, welcome. How did you guys hear about us? The new people that are here, how did you hear about us?
Internet,
what did you find? What site? Okay, you might have found it somewhere. Anybody else? Good, good, good job. Anybody else? Anybody in the newspaper, in business? Good. Referral, fabulous. Referrals are good. Anybody else we missed? Okay, we just like to see what works and what doesn't work. Fabulous. Why are you here? We know why you're here. You're here to see some good deals, to have some fun, to network, to learn. Last meeting, I had a lot of meetings after this event, and I really encourage that. If you guys come to the meeting, get with me. I've done a lot of real estate both locally and nationally and internationally, and I appreciate it when you guys call me up. We get together, we'll have a coffee or something, and we can talk real estate. So, you know, my schedule's tight, but, you know, we can always squeeze people in. So I encourage you to do that. I've got a new office up in the northwest part of town that we opened up about a month ago, so you can come up and meet me there. I'm definitely not going to Henderson. That's way too far. Maybe we'll meet halfway. 1031 money. I want to encourage people. David's here, my 1031 guy, and I didn't expect him to come in. He came in last minute, but I put this in the PowerPoint earlier. 1031 money, a lot of people own a lot of real estate right now. And my philosophy is that there's certain markets that aren't going to go up for a while. So it's not a bad time if you can liquidate and put that money into other markets. And so I really encourage people to do that. I'm trying to liquidate just a couple of my properties, but I've already got places to put that money. So keep that in mind. If you do own property that's got some good equity in it, you'll want to do that. The other thing I want to mention, everything here is not going to be for everybody. So with that being said, you want to make sure that you pick everything up you do, everything up that you see, because you may not like it or it might not make sense to you, but if you pick something up, it might make sense to you down the road. You also have the opportunity to take that and analyze it and look at something so you can say, well, I'm familiar with that, because 3 months down the road, it might make more sense, or 6 months down the road, you might be in a position to look at it. So I encourage you to do that. You give me the numbers already, Phil, huh? Phil's got the numbers in the back. So all you guys that are speaking, Phil's going to have the numbers, so be careful. You don't want to get behind on your time. This particular meeting is a little bit different than the one we had. We want to mix it up every meeting, so we don't want to be totally consistent. We've got two really good projects tonight to go over. One we put more at the beginning, one toward the end. And we want to encourage you guys to look at the projects. Next month will probably be a little more educational, but we're going to mix it up. Get a copy of every presentation, as I said. Collect as many cards as you can. How many people have been collecting cards of other people tonight? Anybody? A lot of people. Good. Encourage you to do that. We might even give out a prize at the end of the night. Count your cards. See how many you've got. Let's see who's got the most. While you guys are counting, spit it out if you've got a big number.
Four?
Kevin's got four. Anybody beat four?
I got Chip's. They're all mine.
Who's got six? Rose has six. Who else has more than that? That's it? Six wins? Come on, guys. Rose, come on up.
The night is
for
the baby.
Say again?
The night is for the baby.
Tonight is that Shakespeare or what?
That's Kelly.
That's Kelly. You got the big one. Good job. All right. Yeah, it's really important to network, you guys, because you're going to meet people. How many people have met the guys in the back yet? These are the developers. I mean, meet these guys. Get their cards. It's real important that you do that. Where did I put my little thing? Probably in my pocket, right? Oh, well. You found it? Couple of comments. Thank you. A couple of comments from earlier meetings. One, the meeting was too long, so we decided to start a little bit earlier. We'll see if more people arrive if this was too early, but 6:30 seems to work because everybody here got here. We wanted to try to have time for Q&A at every meeting. So one of the things we want to try to do is have, when the presenter's done, have a little bit of time for Q&A. Of course, both developers will be here, so when the projects are done or when the night's over, stick around as long as you want, and they'll be more than happy to answer questions. Some people say there's too many speakers. Other people said there's not enough speakers. So or too many or good variety. So we want to make sure we mix it up. A lot of times what we'll have is we'll have, maybe 6 or 8 speakers, and they might only be 5 or 10 minute increments, but the important thing is you're introduced to something. Like Rich spoke last month about rehabbing for 15 minutes. So if somebody really has interest in rehabbing, then get with Rich after the fact, know that he does rehabbing. 0 minutes. Podría ayudarme. Who knows what that means? Oh, we got some Spanish speakers. George, I know you do. What I'd like people to do is help us build the club. You know, if you guys enjoy the club, and I know you all do because you're back here, you know, the flyers that we email you guys, feel free to forward that on to your friends. Take some cards. Feel free to pass them out. We're now on the on our website. Phil's put the actual club from last month on the website. So you can actually get on there. You can tell your friends to get on there, and they can actually view the club on the website. So this way they can say, hey, that's pretty good. I think I'm going to go there. Free grub, you know. Sponsorships are always going to be open. Sponsorships, of course, you get to sit outside and meet the people coming in, and then you get your minutes of glory as we get you up here for sponsors, and I'll have the sponsors come up in a couple minutes. And the same thing, if you guys find a super speaker, let us know, because I'd like to work the speakers in. Where to find us? RegentClubs.com. Am I in the way, or I'm pretty good? RegentClubs.com. That's the club membership that we joined that actually has a variety of clubs throughout the U.S. This is the first club out of the state of California, and now they've got some in L.A., mostly in Northern California is where they started. National New Builds. Our website for this particular club is MRECLV, which stands for Millionaire Real Estate Club Las Vegas. RockRollAndRealEstate.com. That's the radio station up in the Bay Area that I've been on several times over the last year. It's a really nice little radio station. What they do is they not only cover Northern California, they go into Portland, they go into Los Angeles now. Portland, they go into San Diego. Phoenix, I believe they're going into. So they're going into a lot of different markets. And you can actually get on that website and listen to some of the shows that I've been on over the past year. So it's kind of neat. How many people in the room are realtors? Do we have any realtors? So we got about 4 or 5, about 6 or 8, not too many, but a good number of realtors. For those that are realtors, how many people are doing business primarily just here in Las Vegas? Anybody? So most of you guys on this side are doing business in Las Vegas. What I want to do is, I don't think I've really shared with you guys my story, but I just want to go over real quickly my story and what I've done in the last couple of years so that I can maybe open your mind as to looking at some other things. I started out as a full-time investor in 2003. And what I did is I went down, or came over here and bought 3 properties for myself. And then when I started to bring other investors back, the builders had started to close out. So I was a little bit late in the game to buy for myself. And with the builders closing stuff out, I realized that, you know, I had to find another market because I really enjoyed the new construction scenario. Put down $1,000, let it take 6-8 months to build, it goes up in value, you can flip it, you can move into it, you can do whatever you want with it, rent it out, you've got equity. Well, when that happened, I started to look around. I looked at several cities, and I liked Phoenix the best. In fact, Roger Cram's in the back. Hi, Roger. How you doing? Roger and Tom, his partner, I met 3-4 years ago in Phoenix when I just went down there and started to buy. But I ended up taking a bunch of investors down there and buying, and I sold about 100 houses down there as an unlicensed agent. So I didn't get paid commissions on it, but I made a lot of happy investors. I bought 6 for myself. I probably had 400,000 or 500,000 equity between those 6. So I did really well. But I also learned that I could find good value. I could sell to investors. And it worked out great for me. So I knew what was going to happen in Phoenix before the Phoenix people did because I saw what happened in Vegas. So I had the advantage over the Phoenix guys that they didn't have because I already did it in one market.